बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। सिक्स क्लास वी आर स्टार्टिंग द रिवीजन ऑफ आवर फर्स्ट असेसमेंट। नंबर चैप्टर नंबर वन इज साइंस स्किल्स। व्हाट इज साइंस? व्हाट इज साइंस? साइंस इज अबाउट ऑब्टेनिंग नॉलेज बाय ऑब्जर्वेशन, एक्सपेरिमेंटेशन एंड यूजिंग द नॉलेज टू डिस्क्राइब एंड एक्सप्लेन द नेचुरल थिंग्स। एक्चुअली व्हाट इज साइंस? साइंस इज ऑब्जर्वेशन व्हाट, वाई, वेयर एंड व्हेन। अबाउट व्हाट, वाई, वेयर एंड व्हेन। क्लियर? So it's about that. So there are the main three branches of science. They are bio, chemistry, physics. Bio was related. Bio is related to the living things. They are you can say plants, animals, birds, human beings. And the chemistry is the study about the chemicals and about the substances. And the physics is the branch that deals in measuring the things, that is about study physical thing, the study about the physical things about around us. And here, have you ever seen the laboratory? So here are given some laboratory rules, how to do, how to work in laboratories. So how to take the measurements, taking measurements in everyday life and when carrying out scientific experiments. So we have to take the measurements of some things. They are like length. If you want to measure the height, length of a thing, so we use the scale length. And volume, if you want to measure the size of an object. And the units were also given of volume and length. Mass was also the amount of matter in something, and the temperature, and also given the units of temperature over here. Time, how to measure the time? Time can be measured with a stop clock or stopwatch. So this is the unit, and the units of time are hours, minutes and seconds. So here are the few questions about this topic. Now making the difficult measurements, how to make the measurements, then the measurement of temperature, then how to represent that on the chart, and through the pie chart how we can divide a measurement and a quantity according to the pie chart, if that is in the form of person. How to do a scientific investigation? First we prepare, then we take the hypothesis, then we make a variable, and then we do a fair test of that. Clear? Here was the given an experiment of an investigation was given, that how the things can melt in the time, that is also measured, and that is also given over here. After completing this chapter, you have to do the objective first. You have to solve the objective, and then from the textbook and also from the workbook. Now come for the second chapter, that is about life and living things. Life and living things, one significant is common, that they are all alive. About life and living things, what is the life process? There are seven characteristics of life processes. The main characteristics were given over here, that animals feed and produce energy to grow, and the second one was the growth, and the third one was acceleration. First process was feeding, second was growth, third was their acceleration, and the fourth process was movement, and the fifth process was response. Sixth process was reproduction, and the seventh process was respiration. About living things. Now here are the definition about something about cells. What are cells? Unicellular and multicellular, and these are the microorganisms. And if we are talking about the microorganisms, so obviously they can be seen through the microscope. So here is given a microscope, and it is labeled with its different parts, and here is also given the functioning and working of the microscope. And now topic is about animal cells and plant cells. The difference between animal cells and plant cells: there are nucleus, cytoplasm, cell membrane, cell wall, एंड क्लोरोप्लास्ट क्लोरोफिल द प्रोसेस ऑफ फोटोसिंथेसिस एंड द वैक्यूल एंड कंपैरिजन ऑफ द ह्यूमन द सेल्स एनिमल सेल्स एंड प्लांट सेल वाज गिवन आल्सो ओवर हियर स्पेशल सेल्स फॉर स्पेशल जॉब्स हियर आर गिवन सम स्पेशल सेल्स एंड देयर आर डिफरेंट जॉब्स टू डू देम नर्व सेल्स आर गिवन ओवर हियर विद द स्पेशल जॉब epithelial cells are given over here with their jobs nerve cells they are long and fiber like cells and their job is to carry messages to the one part of the body to these nerve cells carry message from one part of the body to another the second thing was epithelial cells they are thin flared cells and they are found into the covering of surface and their function is in the skin lining of the blood vessels and in elementary cell canal and they cells help to in protein protection and absorption and the special cells they are known as pollen grains cells and these pollen grains are sticky surface and they are stuck with the bodies of insects and they also enable them to be carried through wind both adaptations help in pollination next thing is red blood cells these are used to carry oxygen throughout the body they have a large surface area to pick up lots of oxygen cells tissues and organs what are cells what are tissues and what are organs A group of similar cells doing the same job is known as tissue and different tissues combine to make an organ clear so here are some tissues and the organs and they are working what is the organ system that is breathing system when the different organs combine different cells tissues combine together and they make the organ and the organ systems are breathing digestive system nervous system excretory system and circulatory system breathing system helps us to take breath in oxygen and take carbon dioxide nervous system digestive system was about to digest the food through using liver stomach small intestine and large intestine then there was the nervous system depending upon that brain spinal cord and nerves that carry messages from one part to the other part of the body and take the message back and then the excretory system was used to get rid of poisonous substances from the blood and controls water levels into the body kidney and bladder urethra was the main parts circulatory system is used and the working of circulatory system is to supply blood to the whole parts of the body now here are the sense organs that is eye how many parts of the eyes and what are their workings and how does that work and the second sense organ there are five senses that is sense of sight sense of hearing sense of tasting and sense of touch and sense of smell so the working of the eyes and then the ears how do the ears hear and then how do the skin feels what are the surfaces of the skin and what are the functioning and working and then the tasting the sense to taste tongue was the main organ and how the taste buds work what how which sense of smell is used nose and what is the functioning of your nose After completely revising this chapter, you are able to fill the multiple choice questions and the true false statements and the next to draw the diagrams and also to label the diagrams. You have to do the thing that is to complete your MCQs from your textbook and also from your workbook.